Good afternoon and welcome to Hamline United Methodist Church in St. Paul, Minnesota. My name is David Kazizek. I'm the director of music here, and today for our Friday lunch live stream, we are joined by Hamline's very own organist, Eileen Miller. Eileen has been a church organist for over 30 years in Presbyterian, Lutheran, and Methodist churches in Richmond, Virginia, Los Angeles, and the Twin Cities. She is a member of the American Guild of Organists, serving on the board of the Los Angeles chapter and in the Twin Cities as a board member and dean of the chapter. She has been a public school music teacher in Los Angeles and the Twin Cities and recently retired from teaching middle school music in Maplewood. Her Bachelor of Arts degree in music education is from Jamestown College, where she studied organ with William Kuhlman, Susan Hegberg, and William Wojner. We are very happy to have Eileen with us today, and her first selection will be Prelude for Organ by Fanny Mendelssohn.
Thank you for joining us today. After opening the program with Fanny Mendelssohn's Prelude for Organ, I'd like to continue with a couple pieces by two more wonderful women composers. Fanny Mendelssohn was from the Romantic period of the 1800s, and the next piece is from the period preceding, the Classical period beginning in 1750. Maria Theresa Paradis was an Austrian composer and musician. Her father was Secretary of Commerce for Empress Maria Theresa, and Maria was named after the Empress. Maria was acquainted with the leading composers of the day, and she often commissioned pieces by composers such as Salieri and Haydn to play in Vienna. And when she went on tour to Paris and London, she stopped in Salzburg on the way to visit her friends, the Mozarts. Later in life, she spent more time composing, and she founded her own music school for young girls in Vienna. I'm going to play her lovely piece, Sicilian, followed by a piece by contemporary composer Emma Lou Diemer. Emma is professor emeritus at the University of California, and a few years ago was named Composer of the Year by the American Guild of Organists. I'm going to play her comforting arrangement of Come, Ye Disconsolate.
Thank you.
The next three pieces are all by American composer Richard Purvis, who was organist and choirmaster at Grace Cathedral in San Francisco for many years. He had the privilege of studying with Marcel Dupré in Paris. During World War II, when he served in the army, he found himself in Paris again, this time as bandmaster of the first band to march through the streets of Paris following its liberation. I'm going to play three pieces from a collection he wrote in a foxhole under enemy fire, beginning with a beautiful pastorale and canzona, and concluding with Grand Choir, a triumphant piece based on a theme by Haydn.
Thank you.
I have missed being able to travel during the pandemic, as I'm sure many of you have. I organized all my digital travel pictures. It started as an item on my to-do list, but I soon discovered it therapeutic to look at pictures of people and places I've enjoyed visiting. Reliving those good memories inspired a travel theme for the final section of the program. I've chosen going to take a sentimental journey, and I love to go a-wandering. Before those last pieces, I'd like to begin, though, with a gem of a piece by African-American composer Ralph Simpson, his beautiful arrangement of Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. Thank you for joining us today to listen to the beautiful sounds of the organ at Hamline Church. Best wishes to you and your family and friends for good health and much happiness.